Hello everybody, welcome to T-Studio Demos. Today I'll be demonstrating how to do transfer of scale, which is useful in understanding perspective. Make sure you have all supplies ready before you begin, including paper, a sharpened red pencil, a sharpened graphite pencil, eraser, I'm using a kneaded eraser, a ruler, and a 30-60-90 triangle. Before we begin, we should have a quick reminder about some of the basic rules of perspective drawing. Number one, as objects move away from us, they appear smaller than they actually are, and we call this diminution. Number two, parallel lines that move away from us in space appear to come together at a point on the horizon, which we call the vanishing point. This is called convergence. And number three, the space between objects appears smaller and smaller as objects move away from us in space. This is called foreshortening. Today's drawing is going to deal with transfer of scale, and it will demonstrate this first rule, diminution. You see that I am working with a paper in what is called landscape format. That means that the paper is wider than it is tall. This orientation works great for making perspective drawings. Also, make sure that you keep your pencils nice and sharp throughout the drawing process. This helps with accuracy and will maintain a neat appearance to your work. And draw lightly, just in case you need to erase any errors. Using your ruler and a sharp red pencil, draw a horizontal line across your paper. This is the line that represents the horizon or eye level line of the viewer. Make sure it is parallel to the top and bottom of your page and label it HL. Now, locate a point on that horizon line directly in the center of your paper. This point is the vanishing point, and all diagonal lines that represent depth will converge to this point. This center point is also our center of vision, as it is direction the viewer is looking, so make sure to label this point VP for vanishing point and CV for center of vision. Now, using your graphite pencil, draw a vertical line anywhere on your page. Make sure that it is perfectly vertical. Then, going back to the red pencil, connect the top and bottom of this line with the vanishing point. These two diagonal lines will represent the location of the top and bottom of this line if it were to move back into space. So, we can locate other vertical lines using these two as guides. When we are finished, we have a representation of a line drawn multiple times as it moves back into space. We can repeat this process with lines drawn at different places around the page, including vertical and horizontal.